In this lesson, we're going to learn how to create a Houdini digital asset in Houdini, take that asset and load it in the Unity editor using the Houdini engine. To start, we're here in Houdini, where we're going to click on the grid tool and press enter to place at the origin. We're going to set the size of this to 3 and 2, and set the number of columns to 3 and 4. This creates a nice simple grid here for us to work with. Next, we're going to create a box, place it at the origin, and we're going to create a column out of this. So we're going to double-click into here. We're going to just say this, change the size to 0.1 in these two sizes, and then we're going to change the center here to 0.5, which is essentially half of the height. Go back to the object level. With the column selected, we can now go to the Modify menu, say Copy to Points, select the grid, and press Enter. And the columns are currently going sideways, but all we have to do is uncheck this button here and they'll flip back up. Okay, next we're going to add a box node right here and use the tab key and then type BOX to bring that in. Now we're going to make this 0.1 in height and we're going to make it size, let's say 3.5 and 2.5 in this direction to basically create a slab of concrete that we can work with here. And we're going to raise that up one unit. Now if we go tab merge, we can now feed the box and the slab together to create basically a single floor of a building. Next we're going to go tab duplicate. And we're going to display that by clicking here and set the transform to 1. And let's make the number of copies 3. Go spacebar A, you'll see we have a nice little building here that we've created in Houdini. So what we'd like to do now is, let's just add one more node, tab normal. Put that down and we'll be able to wire that in to create a little bit better edge smoothness there. So let's turn this into a digital asset. Zoom out, select all the nodes. We're going to go asset, new digital asset from selection. From here we can say and then we're going to locate that just on the desktop and we're going to say building.hta and we'll just say building. So building, accept. Okay, now this opens up a window which we don't need right now, so we're just going to press accept for now, and we're going to go asset, and we're going to go save asset, just to make sure that's saved. Let's now go to the Unity editor, where essentially we've got the Houdini engine already loaded and ready to go. We take the Houdini engine, we say load Houdini asset, we go to the desktop, select building, and open. So here's our building where we can now look around, tumble around, and zoom out. So you see that all the different levels that we created in Houdini are all brought in and ready to go here in Unity. What we'd like to do now, and one of the powers of the Houdini engine, and is the ability to add controls for this. So we're going to go back into Houdini, and we're going to go Asset, Edit Asset Properties, Building. From this window here, we can go to a tab called Parameters, where we can build up a user interface. Now if we double-click into the node, we can take, for instance, the duplicate here, and say, take the number of copies, and drag that over. We'll just call that Floors. And press Accept. Go Asset, Save Building. Now if we go back to Unity, we can now rebuild that asset and you'll see that we now have the ability to add as many floors as we want right here in Unity. And this is sort of the essence of how Houdini digital assets work and how they interact in Unity. Of course, now we could create controls for the size of the floor, for the width of the column, for how many columns there are, and continue to add those kinds of parameters to make this a more complicated asset. But for now, this is a good starting point.